Lord. Good morning to everybody and welcome to another VPI Sunday morning worship experience. We give God praise and thanks for life, for health, for strength. Our mental faculties are intact. Amen. And I'm just so happy to be here. I'm happy that you are here. Amen. Good morning. Welcome. Amen. And as you jump in, would you be so kind to just touch the share button so that somebody else can be a part of what's happening this morning? In Jesus' name, God bless you. Glad that you're here. Amen. At VPI, you know how we do it. We honor God. We celebrate people. We change lives. And we aspire to impact the world. And we are so glad that you will take some time to be with us this morning. Certainly, amen, it is our hope, it is our desire that those things that we continue to share with you would be those things that the Lord will have us share and that they are inspiring, uplifting, edifying, amen, fulfilling, amen, consoling even in Jesus' name. Welcome to the Sunday morning worship experience here at VPI. Starting it with a little reggae music this morning, amen. Just to lift your heart, lift your spirit, amen. Move your feet a little bit. Beautiful song by my friend, Miss Sherman John.
You picked me up when I was dry. You filled my cup, my forward prayers. I never stopped, and all in all, you've been my rock.
Everybody, let me see you put up on a hand. Everybody don't know how this life is up one. If you don't have money, then are you them grand span? But me not like wicked people. Try to hold me down, cause I come from down and I wait for love until everybody have a plan.
Oh, yes.
That life, but some people just can't understand. Me say what a tragedy, me say what a bang bang.
My peace I give unto you, but not like the world gives.
Top of the morning to everybody.
No, and don't you be afraid, I'll always be there for you until the end of time.
Oh yes.
Time. I keep stressing now, you're invested and I keep pressing. It's a blessing, it's your grace and your mercy that I follow me everywhere I go. So you're to hear me upon that flow in your.
Hey, Vanetta, good morning to you. Marlene, good morning. Laura, good morning. Amy, good morning. Joy, good morning. Dionys, good morning. Jacqueline, good morning. Kathleen Gibson, good morning to you. Joy, good morning. Pastor Jenny, good morning. Welcome. Anne-Marie, good morning. How do I pronounce this? Erlina, I hope I got that right. Good morning to you. Amen, amen, amen. I'm going to take a little more of this joy thing right here. Amen, amen. I'm going to take a little more of that. Take a little more of that. Amen. Yeah. It's that kind of morning. Amen. I hope I pronounce your name right then. I seen Karen Richards. I could get that one. But that other part of the name gave me a little trouble. Anne-Marie, we come. Good morning to you. Melissa Reed, what's up there, girl? Carleen, good morning to you. Darlene, good morning. Sharon Pierre, good morning to you. Suzette, what's up there? Joy, good morning. Carleen Romeo, good morning. Donna, what's up? Good morning. Lawrence, oh Lord, Father help me. Lawrence, good morning. Cousin Laura, what's up there, lady? You good? Amen. Michelle, good morning. Sister Paula, you rich? I see you. Good morning. Lady Patsy King, good morning to you. Welcome. Royston, good morning, my brother. Johnny, what's up there, King? Bless you. Good morning. Angela, good morning to you. Hey, Lady Paula, good morning. Long time no see. Blessings to you. Oh, yes. Oh, yes, 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 yes. Marissa, what's up there? Nadine, good morning. Oh, yes, oh, yes, oh, yes. See who else we got here? Denise, good morning. Sister Carleen, what's up there? Good morning. Cliff, my brethren, good morning to you. Lady Jennifer Bruce, good morning. Welcome. Trista, good morning to you. Dulce, good morning, good morning. Welcome, everybody. Gifta, good morning. Rock a little bit this morning.
This joy that I have, yeah, you couldn't take it from me. I said it's bubbling on the inside, yeah, when I turn, you couldn't take it from me. I said it's bubbling on the inside.
Jojo Benjamin, good morning to you.
Take it from me. Whoa. Why don't you know that Jesus Christ up on the inside? Well, everybody, let me see you put up on a hand. Everybody don't know how this life is up one. If you don't have money, then are you them grand span? But me not let wicked people try to hold me down. Could I come from down and away for love until everybody have a plan?
Henry, good morning. Marianne, good morning.
Stand, me say what a tragedy. Me say what a bang bang. My peace I give unto you, but not like the world gives. So don't you ever worry.
Hey sis, good morning to you. Welcome, welcome.
I'll always be there for you until the end of time. Time. I keep stressing now, you're invested and I keep pressing. It's a blessing, it's your grace and your mercy that I find.
Sharon Davidson, good morning to you. Monica, good morning, what's up there?
There's fullness of joy, and at your right hand, there are pleasures forevermore. This joy that I have, the world didn't give it to me. I said this joy that I have, yeah, you couldn't take it from me. I said it's bubbling on the inside.
Oh yes, oh yes.
You couldn't take it from me.
Yeah, 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 yeah. Amen, amen, amen. I want to call my friend. I want to call on my friend to say something to you this morning. Yeah, 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 yeah. This is my friend. Yes. This is dedicated to all of you.
Greetings to all the saints in Christ. Love, peace, and joy.
Sonia, good morning.
Bless up from Jamaica.
Yeah, man.
Bless up, one love.
Greet you in the love of the Father.
Hey!
Greet you in the love of the Father.
Eva Chapman!
Greet you in the love of the Father. Greet you in the love.
Get ready to move, somebody! Sunday morning.
Give unto you good measure, pressed down, sugar together, running over.
feeling it and I'm feeling it, I'm feeling it. One more time, one more time. Let me see this one to make you all move. Let me see, let me see. Here we go.
Da day da da
da day da da
dum dum da day da 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 da. You know,
come down, see man, come down, see move
something
man.
Something else, sometimes enough. Pain in your heart, pain in your soul,
hey.
Trouble in your path. Life taking a toll.
Ah.
When you look around, oh. Like help out to find. You have to be strong. Put that in your mind. So pick up yourself. When you feel your strength is gone, pick up yourself.
Reverend Webster, good morning.
No way to go on. Pick up yourself. And trust in God above. Pick up yourself.
Pick up yourself, man.
Nothing to stop is love. Things going real good. Then pressure just start.
Hey.
Walking as you should. You check in your heart. You can't understand.
You can't understand.
Like God gone away. Calling on the man.
Nothing he will say.
So pick up yourself.
Pick up yourself.
When praying night and day, pick up yourself.
Pick up yourself.
When things remain same way,
pick up yourself.
There's a time for everything.
Pick up yourself.
Something real good coming. It is a fact that life can get rough sometimes. I mean, sometimes you feel like you're all alone. And you gotta find a way to pick yourself up. You have to find a way. You hear?
This thing we call life have its ups and downs. Turmoil and strife will knock you to the ground. But we have a God that watches over all. Such a caring Lord who will never make you fall.
So pick up yourself.
Pick up yourself.
Jesus is there for you.
Hey.
Pick up yourself.
Tune by tune, tune.
Just what to do.
Pick up yourself.
You're coming out on top.
Pick up yourself.
No one ever made to give up. So pick up yourself.
Pick up yourself.
I tell you, now, pick up yourself.
Pick up yourself.
Pick up yourself.
Pick up yourself.
Pick up yourself. So pick up yourself.
Pick up yourself.
Come on, hey, come on, hey.
Pick up yourself.
Better find a way, my brother.
Pick up yourself.
Better find a way, my sister.
I'm telling you, pick up yourself.
Just pick yourself up.
You don't care what nobody say.
Pick up yourself.
Pick up yourself.
I'm telling you, pick up yourself.
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 Judah Peter's voice.
Woman.
Pick up yourself.
Pick up yourself.
Yeah, man. Thank you.
Pick up yourself. I'm telling you, pick up yourself.
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 I'm telling you, pick up yourself.
Pick up yourself.
All right, let me stop, 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 let me stop. All right, you know, let me calm down. Let me calm down, let me calm down, let me calm down. Yes. It's that kind of morning. Special request for somebody. Yes. Listen, listen. My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. On Christ the solid, solid rock I stand. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but wholly lean on Jesus' name, on Christ the solid, solid rock I stand there all alone. Let me stop. Listen. Let me stop. Amen. Let's come back. Right. I'm just overexcited this morning. I'm just happy. I'm just thankful to God for what He has done and what He's doing. Amen. In your life and my life and all of that good stuff. Amen. In Jesus' name. And sometimes we have to control ourselves in our exuberance and all of that stuff. In Jesus' name. I trust you're well. And I'm really happy that you guys could join us here this morning. You certainly could have been elsewhere. In Jesus' name. And I wanted to share a few things with you today. In Jesus' name, I'm reading from the book of Galatians. And our theme today is, if you want to reap good, then sow good. If you want to reap good, then sow good. Amen. And reading Galatians chapter 6. From verse number 6 down to verse number 10. Amen. Bless the Lord. Let him that is taught in the word communicate unto him that teacheth in all good things. Amen. Let him that is taught in the word communicate or share with him that teacheth in all good things. So there must be a reciprocation between teacher and student. Be not deceived. Verse 7. God is not mocked. For whatsoever a man soweth, that shall he reap. Glory to God. Amen. For he that soweth to his flesh shall of the flesh reap corruption or destruction. But he that soweth to the Spirit shall of the Spirit reap life everlasting. Verse 9. Let us not be weary in well-doing, for in due season we shall reap if we faint not. Verse 10. As we have therefore opportunity, let us do good unto all men, especially unto them who are of the household of faith. If you want to reap good, you must sow good. About a week and a half, 2 weeks ago, I received a call from a very good friend of mine regarding one of her relatives and the living conditions of that particular relative. And she asked me if I will, in my capacity as an elected official, to do something to assist. And so I went to see the conditions under which these individuals were living and so on. And I got there with the help of a very dear friend from the area, and got there and saw a family of five living in just heart-rending conditions. And of course, this situation, Any human being seeing these conditions would be touched. It so happened that this family resides in the constituency of my colleague and dear friend, Dr. Faith. And so we decided to put our minds together and put our hearts together and see what we can do. They have been doing work, I learned, in fact, trying to help the family whatever way they could and so on. And we just decided to combine our efforts to see what more we can do to improve the living conditions of this family. Another gentleman got involved and so on, and his heart went out as well. And he did his thing and pointed me to a house, a board structure that was for sale. And he said, you know, Pastor, if we could buy this house, we will move it from where it is, and then we can reconstruct it, put it on this property where this family lives. This will improve their living conditions. And I said to myself, you know, let me find the money. I remember borrowing the money to purchase that house. And I did so. And we were moving ahead. And I said, you know what, I'm going to do a virtual event that will serve as a fundraiser that I will be able to pay back this money that I borrowed to purchase this wooden structure to assist this family. About 2 days later, I got a call from a lady from the US. She lives somewhere in the New York area. And she said to me, she said, I was riding on the train and God spoke to me and said to send you some money to help you with what you're doing in Tobago. My brothers and sisters, you know, this testimony is significant and connected to the message, and that's why I'm sharing it with you. And when she sent the money, it was enough to pay back the loan for the house. It was enough to give some of my other colleagues, help them with their programs in the different communities and so on. It was enough. It was just enough. It was, and I said to myself, it confirmed to me. I mean, it is something that I have known and I've heard about it, and many of you can also say that this is true. But it confirmed, it reinforced it in my mind that if you sow good, that you will reap good. And so this morning, my brothers and sisters, you know, this life that we are called upon to engage in, this Christianity and so on, is a very practical life. Do not be fooled. A lot of people try to mystify Christianity and they try to make it something out there in the stratosphere. It is a practical life. And it is a fact that what you sow in this life, that is exactly what you will reap. And of course, this is in the general sense of the word. And if you really check it, sometimes you look at people's lives today. You look at the lot of a lot of people. You look at the conditions that people are in. Oftentimes, you will find that the life that people experience today is as a result of seeds that they sowed yesterday. In Jesus' name. The lot of people, the conditions under which you see them operating, has a lot to do with that which was sowed. And I want to say to you today, my brothers and sisters, if you want to see good in this life, if you want to experience all the words good in every facet, all you have to do is to sow good, is to invest good, in Jesus' name. Bless the Lord. And Paul is making a profound statement in these verses. They are nuggets to help us all. Bless the Lord. And as he begins to talk to these people in Galatia, he says to them, amen, bless God. You have to understand, he begins by giving them what I call sobering insight. Sobering insight. In verse 6 and 7, he said, listen, you have to understand, there has to be a relationship between those that are teaching and those that are learning, between teacher and student. Glory to God. Amen. People that invest in your life, people that invest in your development, people that invest in your expansion, people that invest in your maturity, you have to have some kind of connection. It is a principle that as they invest in you, you must be prepared to release something back unto them. Glory to God. And oftentimes when we speak about this, we talk about monetary stuff. And it doesn't always have to be money, because the times in which this was written, it was not so much money that they were talking about, but was just goods, physical things, things that will be a blessing, things that will assist, will speak, amen, as an encouragement and to speak to your gratitude for what that person or those persons have invested in you. And anytime people invest things in you that are good, things that help uplift you, you must be in a place where you say, I have to reciprocate in some way. Thank you, Lord. This is what Paul is teaching them, the principle, amen, of reciprocation. Hallelujah to the Lamb. If somebody has blessed you, and he's speaking primarily here about those that are teaching the word and so on to the saints, but the broader context speaks about anybody that invests anything good in you. Amen. Anybody that teaches you to be better, you must be prepared to reciprocate. Amen. To bring some gift to them in Jesus' name. Hallelujah to the Lamb. Sobering insight. Glory to God. And he says this, and then he undergirds this point by saying, God is not mocked. You know? In other words, God cannot be measled. God cannot be outsmarted. You understand what I'm saying? God sees everything in Proverbs chapter 15 and verse 3. Amen. The writer says, the eyes of the Lord run to and fro. The eyes of the Lord are in every place, beholding the evil and the good. God sees everything. That God is saying, amen, through Paul, you can't outsmart me. You can't trick me. I am not mocked. Amen. You can't measle me. Thank you, Lord. I see what is going on. Whatsoever you sow, whatsoever you invest, whatsoever activity you engage in, that is what you're going to reap in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. This, my brothers and sisters, is a very sobering insight. And if you check your life now, thank you, Lord. Amen. What you are reaping in large part is because of what you have sowed or what you are sowing. In Jesus' name. Glory to God. Hallelujah to the Lamb. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. If you want to reap good, you have to sow good. This ain't no magic. This is not Obia. Amen. Bless God. Amen. This is not some mystical religious thing out there in the stratosphere. If you sow good, you will reap good. That is what Paul is saying here. Thank you, Lord. And all of us here. All of us here want to reap good. All of us want to have a better life. All of us want to be to advance and so on. Amen. But you have to sow good to reap good. If you put nothing in the ground, you do not get any returns. Amen. Bless God. You know, my grandparents used to say, if you didn't choke, you can't look. Thank you, Lord. In other words, if you didn't put nothing, you cannot, amen, go in the backyard or wherever and trying to reap something and you never plant nothing. Amen. That don't make no sense. That is the work of crazy people. And a lot of times that is what people do. They want all this blessing. They want all this goodness. They want all this greatness for themselves and their families. But when you check the kind of sowing they've been engaged in, it is a contradiction. Hallelujah to the Lamb. And then they want to say amen that somebody worked something on them and all that. No, no, no. It's just the seeds that you put in the ground. Thank you, Lord. Amen. And Paul said, if you spend all your time trying to gratify the flesh and trying to engage in activities that are fleshly, you will reap the rewards of that, which is corruption or destruction. But if you get on a spiritual plane, trying to understand the word of God, the principles of God, the person of God, get on that relationship and engage in spiritual things, you will reap everlasting life. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Amen, 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 amen. So there is some sobering insight in here that Paul gives them. And then he goes on in verse 9. Amen. And he says to them, now that you have this insight, there must be steadfast involvement. Because just having the information and not doing anything does not assist you either. Thank you, Lord. There are some people that know everything. You tell them about scripture, they know scripture. But as it comes to the place of applying what they know, that is the challenge. Thank you, Lord. So he says, look at what he says in verse 9. Hallelujah. Let us not be weary in well-doing. In the light of what I've just told you. In the light of the fact that you understand that when somebody blesses you and somebody invests in you, that you need to reciprocate. You need to reciprocate. You need to give something back. Amen. Bless God. And you understand now that God is not mocked. God sees what's happening. And what you sow, you're going to reap. Amen. You understand that. He says, in the light of this now, don't ever get weary in well-doing. Glory to God. Amen, amen, amen. He speaks about steadfast involvement. Don't get weary. And the reason why he puts it this way, because doing good sometimes could wear you out. Come on here. Amen. Amen. Bless God. Doing good. Listen, give us always give. Give us always give, but receivers don't always end up giving. Come on, yeah. Hallelujah to the Lamb. Amen, amen, amen. Give us always give, but receivers don't always give back. Thank you, Jesus. That's the way. And sometimes there are people that you help, people that you bless. They don't even have thanks in their mouth. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. You go out of your way to assist them. You go, amen, take your last and give them, and they will turn and say some of the most evil things about you, make you out to be the worst person that ever lived. That is the nature of some human beings. But Paul is saying, you must not allow that to get you weary. Thank you, Lord. Don't get weary. The word weary means to lose spirit, to expire, to lose the drive. Amen. To lose interest, to give up on it. He said, don't ever get weary. Why? He said, because in due season. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. I want to help somebody this morning. He's saying, listen, there is a set time for your return. Glory to God. Amen. But you have to understand, your return is directly connected, amen, to your consistency. Notice what he said. If you fail, there is no guarantee that you will reap. Thank you, Lord. Amen, amen. That's why he says, amen, bless God, that you must engage in doing good, amen, and do not get weary. Don't expire. Don't lose hope. Don't stop because of stupid people. Thank you, Jesus. Amen, amen, amen. Because I'm telling you, now, there are some people, the kind of things that they do after you do all stuff for them, after you do stuff, or generally, you do good, and people will turn their backs and say the worst things about you. That can break your spirit. So Paul is encouraging them because he understands this reality. He said, don't get weary. Don't get weary. You understand. Do it. Do good because you want to do good. Thank you, Lord. Amen. Bless. So the time is always right to do right. Eh? Hallelujah to the Lamb. Just do it because, amen, you want to do it. You understand this is what God requires of you, and you do it in Jesus. And you understand too that your reward does not necessarily come from man. Enough. God may use men, but your reward don't really come from man. This is what God is saying. In due season, you shall reap. There is a set time for you to get, amen, your return on that which you have sown. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah to the Lamb. I used to dread when it was time, or like now, so amen, bless God, was dread because, you know, in my house, I had to do all the preparation, amen, for the little piece of land in the back to make sure, amen, that we get the place ready to plant the peas and the corn. And I used to be working there like a horse, amen. And I used to be upset. I used to be upset how it is that my other siblings, my sisters, were not working as hard as me and all that kind of stuff. But there is something about after you go through that season of planting and sowing, thank you, Jesus, and you see the ears of corn and peas begin to come up from the ground, and you protect them from the fowls and all of that, and then you see the ears growing on the corn tree, and bless God, and after a while, amen, when you start seeing the corn coming, you start thinking, Marlene, you know what I'm talking about, you start thinking about boiling corn and roasting corn. You're no longer upset and frustrated about the many mornings when they woke you up to go down in the back to clean the yard, to clean the plot of land rather. You forget about all the horrors, amen, bless God, of working so hard in the back. But now that you see the fruit, hallelujah, there is a joy that comes. My brothers and sisters, there is a season for the thing to come to maturity. Bless the Lord. There is a time and season for the thing to become ripe. There is a time and season. Due season it is called, according to the word of God. In other words, it is an appointed time that nothing could stop. Hear me. You have some trees in your backyard. Amen. There is a season when those trees will flower, and there's a season when, bless God, the fruit will come and the fruit will mature. You could hold a prayer meeting. You could do what you want. Amen. Or you don't have to do nothing at all. The fruit will still come. Why? Because it is the season. Glory to God. And I'm trying to tell you, no matter what we do, we don't stop the season. We don't prevent seasons. Amen. There is a time for the thing to be fruited. in Jesus' name. As long as you sow it, it is going to manifest. And just as I'm speaking about that which is good and that which is illustrious and that which is great, it is the same thing with that which is evil. And you find that a lot of people, the heartache that they go through, the pain they go through, the disappointments that they go through, it is not that anybody has done them anything. It is not that God is against them. It is because they themselves have sown bitterness and evil and wickedness in the lives of other people. Amen. They've never tried to help nobody. They've never tried to bring peace. They rather, they bring turmoil and destruction. Amen. When they open their mouth is like poison. Amen. Bless God. They weaponize their words against people, and they want people to speak good from them. Amen. Bless. They never give nobody nothing, but they are the first ones to call and say they want gifts when their birthday come along, and they want gifts and such like, and you don't remember nobody's birthday. You never help nobody's children, but you want people to help your children. You never, amen, bless God, celebrate nobody's victory, but you want people to celebrate you. The devil is a liar. What you sow, that is what you're going to reap. And if you love people, people will love you. If you bless people, people will bless you. If you help people, people will help you. You could build your house in the woods. They will cut a beaten path and find your doorstep and bring it there for you, because God has decreed it that once a man sows good, he will reap good in Jesus' name. Hallelujah to the Lamb. Bless the Lord. Hallelujah to the Lamb. Amen, amen. But there's got to be steadfastness in the involvement. You hear me? You got to keep on doing it. You got to keep on sowing. Hallelujah to the Lamb. Bless God. You got to, it must be something that becomes a part of you. Amen. And even when people act the fool, that must not stop you. That must not get you depressed and frustrated. Amen, amen, amen. Let me read it one more time. He said, and let us not be weary of doing good. Amen. Well doing, for in due season we shall reap if we faint not. Hallelujah to the Lamb. I want you to understand today that the reason why we do what we do, amen, it's not just to go to heaven, but while we remain here on the earth, we want to see some good. Amen. Can I get an amen from somebody? You want to see good in your life. You want to see good in your house. You want to see good in your children. You want to see good in your church. You want to see good among your fellowship. You want to see good in the place that you work. So, amen, in order for you to see that, you've got to engage in good works. You've got to assist people that are less fortunate. You got to reach out in Jesus' name. Bless the Lord. Amen. He said, let us not get weary. Let us not get weary. Don't get weary. Don't get fed up. Don't get depressed. Don't get frustrated. Don't lose spirit in Jesus' name. Hallelujah to the Lamb. These are some sobering nuggets. The first one, Paul says, is the sobering insights. We understand that God is not mocked. We understand we have a responsibility to bless people who bless us. We have a responsibility, amen, to reciprocate good. Thank you, Lord. And we know we can't outsmart God. Amen, amen, amen. Bless God. And then the steadfast involvement engages, amen, our getting involved and not getting weary. The last point is this. There must be sensible initiatives. Sensible initiatives. Look at verse 10 and I'm done. I'm going to leave you alone this morning. Hallelujah. He says now, verse 9 says, let us not get weary in well-doing, for in due season we shall reap if we faint not. Verse 10 says, as we therefore have opportunity, as a result of what we have just been discussing, so as an opportunity arises, thank you, Lord, let us do good unto all men. In other words, there must be no line of demarcation as to who you do good to. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah to the Lamb. Amen. And then he says, especially unto them that are the household of faith. Now he gives a little, amen, bless God, a little leeway, saying, amen, that you must have a kind of preference. You can have a preference, amen, bless God. But notice, he's saying, we must do good unto all men. Do good unto all men. Amen. He says, this includes them on the household of faith. But he also is saying that there is an extra blessing when you come to those that are the household of faith. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah to the Lamb. Amen, 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 amen. So all men, it doesn't matter what is your spiritual condition. It doesn't matter what is your religious persuasion. It doesn't matter what's your ethnic group. It doesn't matter who you are. Amen, bless God. None of that kind of stuff. Once I have path. I see the opportunity, amen, to do something good. I'm going to do it in Jesus. And that is what Paul is teaching. And this really speaks about how we can improve the world and the environment in which we live in. Because people live their lives, and you don't always have control over people who live their life. And you must never, amen, bless God, become God. Amen. If you have the opportunity to do something good to somebody that you don't even like, you must do good. Because this is about the reciprocation that's going to come back to you. It is not about them. It is about you. Let me tell you this, my brothers and sisters. Doing good is for you, not for them. Amen, 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 amen. Bless the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. I'm going to say that again. Your engagement in well-doing is not for the people. It is for you. It is for your harvest. It is for your return. It is for your blessing. It is for your future. You are investing in a good future when you engage in good activities across the board. When you help somebody that is underprivileged. When you see somebody in need. When there is a need, there is a situation. When you see a benevolence activity, an opportunity, take advantage of it in Jesus' name. Amen. As the opportunity arises, engage in good. Glory to God. Amen. Do good unto all men. If you want to reap good, you must sow good. In Jesus' name. I'm done. I'm done. I'm done. I'm done. I'm done. Glory to God. It is as simple as that. Life, this Christian life, ain't no magic. It ain't all that sophistication and complexity that sometimes people make it out to be. Amen. It is about practically living your life and let your life be a blessing to others. It is about shining your light among men that they will see your good works and glorify the Father which is in heaven. That you must not take a light and put it under a bushel, but you put it on a mountain and everybody could see. They must know that because Jesus touched you, he didn't just touch you to go in church and act pious, but he touched you so that you could be a blessing, so that you could assist in the upliftment of your community. You can assist in the betterment of somebody else's life. Christianity has no use if it does not touch people. Christianity is a useless religious exercise if it does not improve the lives of individuals. And that is what, and no wonder Jesus says, in the final eschaton, when we stand before him, it's not going to be well said, thou good and faithful servant. It is well done. Hallelujah. Blessed. So your life, in essence, is not measured by your duration. It's not measured by your sentiments that you speak, but rather by your donation or your activity that you engage in while you live here. In Jesus' name, the 3 points that I raised with you this morning. Amen. Point number one, sobering insight. Amen. Bless God. Point number two, steadfast involvement. Point number three, sensible initiatives. In Jesus' name. Amen. If you want, amen, to have good, if you want to enjoy good, if you want to reap good, then you must sow good. It is that simple and practical. Let me pray for you. Father, we give you thanks. We give you praise, honor, and glory because you are good. Your word is true. Your word is sure. There is none to be compared with you. Thank you for the grace that you bestowed upon us on this session today. Thank you for the importance of this simple but profound principle. Thank you, Lord God, for every person that took the time to be a part of this session today. I pray now that your blessing would be upon us and that we will activate that which we have heard, that in order for us to enjoy that which we want to enjoy, that we will make the necessary sacrifice, sow the various seeds so that we can reap them. We give you thanks and we give you praise for doing it and for helping us all. In Jesus' mighty name, amen and amen and amen. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. In Jesus' name, have a super fantastic day. Remember, if somebody sows something into you that uplifts you, amen, bless God, that blesses you, you have a responsibility to reciprocate to them. In Jesus' name. And as you get the opportunity to do good to all men, engage in it. It is for your own good and for your own benefit. God bless you. I'm done. Have a super day. We're going to talk again in Jesus' name. Bye-bye.